Hello there, this is Red Joy, and this is very exciting. It's not a huge, massive playthrough today. I just want to show you guys the return of the City of Heroes Homecoming, right? Those of you who don't know, City of Heroes was an MMORPG created by NCSoft, and it went offline a few years back. They kind of they realized having the subscription model wasn't very profitable, and they basically said they were done with it. A lot of the information on the background scenes I got from another video, and I'll post that in the description below. Basically, the servers all went offline. I want to say back in like 2013, or it may have been even later or earlier than that. But basically, afterwards, there were a number of smaller private servers that were put up there that tried to incorporate all of the additional add-ons and stuff like that for City of Heroes, which, by the way, is a MMORPG where you create a superhero and you go around and save the city. That's it. As you can see from the video that I'm going to show you, there are a ton of options for character creation, for different power sets that you can use. You can customize the power sets to make them a certain color that you like, right? So there's a lot of different unique abilities that you can put into creating a character. So the City of Heroes Homecoming has just come about, and basically I'm going to play a little bit of it. I'm going to do character creation. You have a lot of different possibilities of different characters that you can create. What I will also do is I'm going to put in the description of the video below the link to the Homecoming site to allow for you to get on, download City of Heroes. It's not a big file. It's a pretty standard file. It's an older game, so you're not talking about a massive, you know, Baldur's Gate 3 experience. You're talking about a game that is, you know, it's a little bit dated. It's about 10 years younger than a lot of the other games that I play. 5 years younger than a lot of the games I play. So, you know, there is my my take. This is my take on a martial artist, Sibhaha. I actually don't know how to pronounce her name. I don't know exactly why. It's kind of a test character. But my whole point is I want to just kind of play around and show you guys a little bit of the mechanics of the character. Normally, there's a tutorial that you can do. And of course, being an MMO, there's a lot of other players. One of the nice things about this iteration of City of Heroes is that it gives you a few powers for free that are like fitness powers that help you go even faster and jump higher than a normal person does. So, like, for example, we have Sprint. But even with Sprint, they even like have they have other abilities, other things that cause you to go even faster. And you literally just go around and beat up thugs. And it's an MMO. It's old school MMO. So watching it is a little bit different than actually sitting and playing it. But yeah, that was fun. My first two thugs that I stopped, the Blood Brothers. It's part of a gang called the Blood Brothers. Oh, no, the Hellions, I'm sorry. Yeah, these guys are actually very powerful because I'm only a level 1 character. I don't want to be picking a fight with level 4 characters. Even though I could take down one or two of them, they would beat me up. So, well, I'll just show you a few fights here. And of course, you know, this is just a martial artist, right? If I were to pick a character who had energy, they could blast energy, they could do that. I could create a character who could summon pets. I can create a character who can use telepathy to put people to sleep, or telekinesis to telekinesis to lift people into the air, right? Or magic to, you know, control people, right? Not only that, but you can also create a villain, right? And you can play it from a villain's perspective and start on a, you know, island of evil misfits. And then once you start on this island of evil misfits, you're working for kind of this evil organization, and then eventually they'll send you to attack the good guys, right? So it's kind of an interesting game to play. I think one of the cool parts about it is that there are a lot of other players, and you can create like a superhero team. You could do quests. You could set up a base. A lot of fun things. I had played other superhero MMORPGs before, because this one was the first one that came out. City of Heroes was the first one that came out, and it was. This, by the way, is after I level up the character a little bit. And I didn't enjoy it as much as I should have. Right? I thought that the game was... I thought those other games were kind of... I thought they were a little bit lame. I thought that they... Champions Online... The problem with Champions Online was that it was, like, really... complicated with the, like, intricacies of, like, the, you know, crafting different powers and different abilities and stuff like that. Even though the artwork was beautiful for it, it was just very weird, right? It had a lot of bloat to it. And then DC Online, I didn't like the fact that your character isn't an established character. Like, they aren't, like, they have to have this one origin. That's just a normal Joe that got, like, his powers from Brainiac, and that's the only origin you can go with. And I thought that was pretty limiting as far as superheroes go. But here we can pick new superpowers, right? Whenever you actually level up, you actually go to pick new powers. You can pick enhancement slots for those powers. You can, right at level 5, so if you're a veteran of... I don't do it for this character, but if you're a veteran of the game, at level 5, you could choose your movement power. That's pretty cool. Like, back in the day when I played, it was level 14, and it was a slog. It was a slog to get to that point. But making it level... letting it be level 14 is really, really... I'm sorry, letting it be level 5 is really, really nice. Of course, you can enhance your powers. You could sell old enhancements. Inspirations are little things that you can use in the middle of combat. I don't really run out of energy at this point, so I don't need those. And you could pick up... the big thing I want to pick up is more damage resistance on my invulnerability. So I'm going to go ahead and just pick up a ton of those as soon as I can figure out which one it is. Now, Redjoy, it's the one that says damage resistance. Damage resistance. There we go. I'm sorry, resist damage. So I'll pick up a couple of those. Excuse me. And then we'll go ahead and put these in the slot. I also pick up one that... helps to increase my damage. And then you can... put in a thunder kick. And then you can combine them, right? For example, these two being the same level, they're going to have a 100% chance. I'll do the same for this one. And I'll do the same for this one. There we go. Now I am... 33% more effective at resisting damage. So now I think... What do I end up doing? I think I go ahead and get my first quest. Yes, I get my first quest. It's all dealing with those Hellions. So Sipaha is going to... Yeah, that's how I pronounce it. Sipaha. Was like trying to remember how do I pronounce her name? Sipaha. we're gonna beat up these guys. These guys are nasty, nasty thugs. And every character you create, you can, it's not, so the origin system, literally you type in the description of what your origin is. So that's not very complicated. What you can do though, is you can choose from five different general origins where your character, how your character got their powers, right? For this character, I chose magic, and that's gonna influence the, it's going to influence the quests that I get along the way, right? So, because I chose magic, I might get more magic-based quests. I might stop enemies that are, you know, using the mystical arts or, you know, summoning demons and stuff like that. You can also do mutation. You can do natural, where, like, you're just a naturally trained powerhouse superhero. Science, where you may be a science experiment, so someone like Spider-Man or the Hulk would be science origin. And I think technology is the last one, which is that you use technology, right? So magic, mutation, science, technology, natural. Five origins, right? And so, yeah, so basically you have... So with those five, you can you're gonna get different quests. You also get a single power to be used to a single power to be used in like the, you know, that's a short range little power that everybody can toss out. For her, it's called an apprentice charm. It's just something she tosses out and it causes a minor debuff, right? Or it's very small amount of damage and then it's minor debuff. So, you know, this game does have the kind of standard MMO, you know, fetch, quote-unquote fetch quests of beat up five dudes, then head back to your quest, right? There is a lot of that. The way City of Heroes does it, I just don't mind it as much as, like, going into the forest and killing five boars, right? Maybe it's because I'm not, like, having to also get their boar tusks or... Maybe it's because, like, it has these civilians here, and it's kind of a psychological thing of, oh, okay, I'm going to save the civilians, right? It could be that. But it just doesn't bother me as much as others. Just speed up the video a little bit here. So I also am playing around with, like, the viewpoint, stuff like that. I'm also, you know, looking for, what's the best angle I could do for a thumbnail for this video? Whatever, right? Regardless... So and other heroes are going to come in, and they're completing their quests as well, right? Like archery heroes, heroes that are way more creative than me. There's a steampunk guy I come across a little later on. It's kind of a cool design. Then once we get that, then we can head on out. Give our contact a call. You don't have to run all the way back. Thank God for modern technology. And you can kind of ask some of these early characters about, like, their history. I was just kind of being like, professionally, you don't want to be asking somebody about their dead wife. I don't need this many, but a heal would be good. So we're going to get a heal. Ah, steampunk, yes. So at this point, yep. Okay, skipped a little bit ahead. You know, beat up some dudes there, and then an informant. My goal is just to create a character that just will constantly do attack after attack after attack after attack after attack in melee, so that, like, when one is cooling, when one is all cooled down, the other is heated up, or the one is ready, the other is ready to go. And this is an espionage mission, which is why she looks really weird, and I can't run with the full speed, but we're just gonna make our way. There we go. It's like, she's a sexy demon. Except that's not what the Hellions were. They were just dudes that played with Demoncraft. Took a long time for me to run through that, okay? So now we're ready for the next phase. And we zipped ahead to chat with our... Oh, I could have called him, too. I just realized that. I could have called him. Okay, there's a ritual. See? Demoncraft. Don't play with demons, guys. So we're going to go ahead, and then we move ahead to fight against all these goons that are in here. And this is a story-specific mission. There's not much voice acting at all in this game, so you're not gonna have like characters tell for example, at the end of this, there's gonna be an exchange of between two characters. No voice acting whatsoever, right? This is early odds. Early in the piece. One thing I didn't mention, I'm going to put down in the description below, right, is NCSoft gave this Homecoming, City of Heroes Homecoming, its blessing, right? That is really cool. Like, I applaud NCSoft for doing this, right? Maybe, I'm sure others of you out there are like, oh, NCSoft is the terrible, blah, 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 right? Fine, whatever. But, like, the fact that they looked at this project and instead of shutting it down, they were like, we're gonna let people play our game for free, and basically we will help to maintain these servers. That is so cool. That is really cool. So I applaud them for doing that. So the link is down below. You do have to have an NC account. They're free. You could basically just create an NCSoft account, right? It's right on the website that I'm linking below. You download the game. It's very easy to download. It'll download like that. Go through the prompts, and then you choose what server. We are on, I believe I'm on Everlasting. It's the one I'm on. And you'll see that this quest giver, his wife, is being held prisoner by the evil organization, the organization who you would work with if you joined the villains. I don't know why they had a computer there. It's like an evil... they're like a gang that plays with Demoncraft, and they happen to also have like the Doctor Doom-esque technology there. It's kind of weird. I don't understand it, but it's funny. So we're going to return. I think we go all the way back to the quest giver. I think the reason why I also go back is because I want to level up. I'm very, very close to leveling up. Bada bing, bada boom. Kick to the face. When you level up also, and other MMORPGs may do the same thing, but when you level up, you get a huge, like, you get a whole set of boosts to help protect your behind. Like this dude here, he's going down in, like, 3 hits. He's a lieutenant, he's going down in 3 hits. Granted, he's easier, he's, like, several levels below me, but still. And so we're going to return back to the quest giver, and he's going to send us to our next contact. So, as far as modern day RPGs go, it's nothing complex. But City of Heroes, a lot of fun. It's completely for free. And NCSoft is giving it, it's helping out with management of the servers. So they're doing a great job in supporting it. And you should definitely check it out. So go to the link below, watch the other video. He's got a lot more information about what NCSoft is doing. And a huge shout out to them for kind of catching me on to this. So, if you like what I do, subscribe to the channel. I put out a lot of content. And with that, thank you so much for watching. Take care and good luck. We're all counting on you.